The sound of weapons fire rattled around the capital. The Bosnian peace process appears to be going nowhere. Shelling yesterday killed at least 8 people, according to Bosnian government.
I remember in the spring of 1995 that the general commander of the UNPROFOR, the UN forces there, he said that that year, in fact that season, the Bosnian Serbs would seek to take all the so-called UN safe havens. I'm not sure how many people took him seriously, but there was an assault on Garajde, there was assault on Zepa, and there was this terrible assault on Srebrenica. To this day, you know, the numbers are staggering. 8,000 or so Muslim men and boys slaughtered just because they were Muslim. I remember the terrifying images of General Ratko Mladic walking around the civilians in Srebrenica and telling them not to be afraid. The men were all taken off and the women and children were sort of put to one side. I remember he was trying to give them sweets, and I remember in Serbo-Croat he said, "Don't be afraid." And it was about the most chilling video that I've seen ever in my life, actually, because within hours, these men were slaughtered, the men and the boys. In August of that same year, another huge mortar attack on a market in Sarajevo, and that was the trigger, and NATO bombed for a couple of weeks, and the Serbs cried uncle. This group of, now we know, you know, paper tiger, really, that had held the world at bay for so long. You know, one or two bombs on its positions, and they rolled over. Let's not forget that this was a slaughter of civilians, not a traditional army against army. It was a completely unlevel playing field, right down to the fact that they were perched on the mountains surrounding Sarajevo, and the civilians were in all these valley towns and cities who were being sniped, who were being shelled at bread lines, at water lines, you know, crossing the road, children even, women, old men. It brought out the best in those who resisted and those who survived, who would not surrender. Again, these very same men, women, and children who were being so terribly assaulted in, you know, the 90s on global 24-hour satellite television.
Live from the Carter Presidential Center in Atlanta, CNN presents a global forum.
Mr. President, our next question is from Sarajevo, from CNN correspondent Christiane Amanpour.
Mr. President, it's a privilege to address you from Sarajevo. Do you not think that the constant flip-flops of your administration on the issue of Bosnia sets a very dangerous precedent and would lead people such as Kim Il-sung or other strong people to take you less seriously than you would like to be taken?
No, but speeches like that may make them take me less seriously than I'd like to be taken. There have been no constant flip-flops, madam. I ran for president saying that I would...
This was viewed as a challenge to President Clinton. I hadn't thought of it or planned it or presumed that I was going to do that. He had been speaking about Bosnia. This was 1994, 1 year before Srebrenica and 2 years into this savage war already. And the United States... basically, its arms were tied, it wasn't doing anything. You know, after Never Again, this was very, very difficult for us to stomach as we watched it. And we lived it day in and day out, week, month, you know, year in and year out. And it was my opportunity to ask him a question. It turned into a confrontation. It was, you know, it was awkward for me, probably awkward for the president. But in the end, in hindsight, I think I did the right thing. I asked the only question I could from my vantage point, and it was a very serious and dramatic question about why the world wasn't doing anything to stop a genocide. I wish we could do the same thing in Syria, and I wish that the world would get as serious about ISIS, about defeating ISIS, as they did get as serious about defeating the genocidal Serbian strategy back in 1995.